has it. They go out to Brennan Stroplin. Stroplin drives around. Cheryl Hayes puts it up with the glass. Gets her own rebound, puts up the second effort for two more. Right now, again, like I said in the first half, the Pirates have no answer for Brennan Stroplin. Out of top, it is Cheryl Hayes with a deep three. Go.
She's got to get going. That's a deep three for her. Maybe that's something that'll spark her to go. But, I mean, the Pirates are really concentrating on locking down on Mache Miller, and at this point, she's really not hurting you at all.
Mache scoreless right now. Here's Vardy with the basketball. You better start worrying a little bit more about Brennan Stroplin. Brennan Stroplin's killing him.
That double down on the post, he'll make her work from the outside and see if that gives you any luck, but...
Here's Mache Miller getting the ball from Stroplin, leaves it behind, goes back and gets it. Now it's going to be six on the shot clock. Back out to Stroplin, they leave her all alone. She puts down three more. 42-29. There's a cross-court pass to Cheyenne Hayes. Hayes puts up the shot. That one's no good. And here come the Hawkers again, up by 13. Over to Alexa Vardy. Vardy with the basketball, dribbles to the left elbow, spin move, and then they're tied up. This time the possession arrow will go to the Cuyahoga Pirates. That'll be a turnover called against Kenmare as Cambry Johnson checks in and Peyton Ron checks in for Ava Wallane. Thea Johnson has a seat on the bench as well for the Pirates. Bree Rose comes into the front court, guarded there. Now it's going to be Bree Rose getting fouled as she goes to the basket. Foul's called against number 14, Bria Crest. That's her first personal foul and the non-shooting foul. The Pirates get a fresh 35 on the shot clock. Out to Peyton Ron, now Cambry Johnson with it. Johnson looks for Hayes, finds Cheryl, goes in, puts up the shot with the left hand, no good. It's going to be off the arms of the Kenmare Hawkers. So it stays with Tioga. And
those are the shots that Cheryl needs to knock down. You can't be an all-district player and clank it off the backboard with the left hand. I know it's a tough left-hand shot as Cambry Johnson goes up to one of the foul.
Yeah, Cambry goes to the bucket hard, and we're going to have a foul call against Kenmare. It's going to go against number 15, and Alexa Vardy picked up her third personal foul. That'll send Cambry Johnson to the free throw line to shoot a couple of free throws, and Simmers questioning the Brandon Weber's not having any of it as Cambry makes the first free throw. Taya Offworth will check in. They can't come in now as the ball was already in the hands of Cambry Johnson. So Cambry toes the stripe for the second of two free throws. That one's up and that one's good. Didn't make a difference. Sometimes that upsets the apple cart. Taya Offworth comes into the game replacing Alexa Vardy. Here's Mache Miller, guarded there by Bree Rose. Not only playing offense, Bree is, but she's also playing against Mache Miller. Here is Crest inside Taya Offworth.